we have. The topic is, today's topic is applicability of rules of debit and credit in railway transactions. And the speaker is Senior Instructor Sitara, CM Nageshwar Rao, who is also manager training. Mr. Nageshwar Rao is well known to all the participants who are attending Sitara Zoom meetings. His specialty is in running the blog called Appendix 3 Examination. And apart from being the author and editor of a magazine called Railway Accounts Made Simple, which is published by Sitara. I hope all the participants would be benefited by today's lecture. Over to Mr. Nageshwar Rao.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. Good morning, all of you.
Good morning, sir.
Yes,
sir, visible.
Yeah. Today we are going to cover how the applicability of the rules of debit and credit in the railway transactions. Also, we discuss this karma journey and what is the need of this minus debit and minus credit operations. And we will discuss this approach potency aspect also. Okay. Before that, I am going to meet to everyone. Please, any queries, please note down at the last few minutes to discuss the end of the session. And if any sessions, if any important queries, please type in the chat box so that at the end of the session, we are attending each and every query. Yeah, I'm going to meet all of you. The current topic is applicability of rules of debit and credit in railway transactions. Now, before that, we will just discuss about what is the accountancy and what is accounting. Accounting is an ancient art, certainly as old as money is. Even though in the beginning it was a very basic art, primarily, that is in the 15th century, after that it developed a lot of development in the history. So it is like an art. So, booking or recording of transactions is an art. The simple definition of accounting is a systematic record of the daily events of a business leading to presentation of a complete financial report. So, what is the definition of this accounting? It is a record. How to record it is a systematic record of all the events, of daily transactions, daily events of a business or firm. Our organization, and it is leading to presentation of the complete financial picture, that is the final accounts, that is a trading account or P&L account or balance sheet. Since railway is a department in commercial organization, we need to comply with this government accounts as well as the commercial accounts. And one important part is that is American Institute of Certified Public Accountants is defined the accounting as the art of recording, classifying, and summarizing in a significant manner and in terms of money transactions. This is very, very important. Everything in the money transactions. And the events which are important, at least of a financial character. That means the event should be having a financial character. If it is not financial character, it is not supposed to record in the, there is no format of record in the accounts. और फाइनली आप एक्सपेक्टिंग के रिजल्ट्स दे रहा हूँ दैट इज सर टू फाइनल दैट मीन्स इफ यू डिटेल द डेफिनेशन ऑफ द अबाउट वन इज कैन स्प्लिट इन टू द फर्स्ट वन इज रिकॉर्डिंग ऑफ जनरल एंट्रीज रिकॉर्डिंग ऑफ जनरल एंट्रीज आर रिकॉर्डिंग ऑफ ऑल लार्ज एंट्रीज and the next step is the class penalty transaction as a revenue and capital on the different heads in the ledger. That is the sales account, purchase account, office expenses account, the capital account, assets account, various types of accounts we have made in the ledger. Then summarizing the accounts in a significant manner, that is a trading account, theater account and balance sheet. And the transactions and events of a financial nature only. That means, suppose a promotion of the supervisor or executive or clash between directors cannot be recorded in this financial, it's not possible also. Only the transactions of the financial nature only should be recorded in the journal or and finally, interpreting the results, that is various ratios or between spiral accounts, P&L account, balance sheet, and information to various stakeholders. Here is the main part to management, creditors, government, tax authorities, and research association, research bodies. All these are the stakeholders for the spiral accounts. And he is the very important person, Luca Pasquale. He is regarded as the father of accounting. His book, Sammati, Arithmetica, Geometria, Proportion and Proportionality, is a review of arithmetic and geometric proportions. He authored his book in 1494. It is considered as the first book of the double entry. He was born in the 1494 in Venice. It is treated as the first book of the double entry bookkeeping. Though he did not claim he was the inventor of double entry bookkeeping, but he spread the knowledge through this book. He used this present day popular terms of accounting, what is debit and credit. He first used this in the debit it is, in the Latin it is called debita. Debita means owed or indebted with proprietor. That means owed to the proprietor. This is the credit means it is a trade-off owed by the proprietor. Both are originated from the Latin course. He discussed in his book the details of memorandum or general ledger and specialized accounting procedures. That's why he is regarded as the father of accounting. He is regarded as the father of. Now we check the golden rules of accounting. So all these accounts are classified in three categories. The first one is personal account, real account, and nominal. The personal account rule is that debit the receiver, credit the user. These three rules are called as golden rules. We have to buy or the or we have to understand. This is the basic. Fundamental for all accounting, the accounts are bookkeeping. So the personal account rule is that debit the receiver, credit the giver. Real account rule is that debit what comes in the business and credit what goes out from the business. And the nominal account rule is that debit all expenses and losses, credit all the incomes and gains. These three are very very important. We'll check the examples. See, personal account, it is three categories. That is the natural persons, artificial persons, and the representative persons. Natural persons means the human beings, either Raja account, Krishna account, Venkat account. Artificial persons means like partnership firms or companies, that is Reliance company, Tata company, or Airtel company. And another category is that representative personal account is like a prepaid expenses or income received in advance or outstanding expenses or outstanding income. These credits are called as the representative personal account. So the rule of personal account is the debit the receiver, credit the receiver, credit the real account. It is real account all tangible and intangible properties. It is but all assets are called comes under real account. Tangible properties that means you can touch, that is a buildings, machinery, inventory or stores or cash. Intangible properties means goodwill, patents, copyrights. These are the intangible properties, both comes under real account. The real account tool is the what comes in the business, what comes in the business, and credit is the what goes out from the business. And the last one is nominal account. Nominal account is the all expenses are reduced. Expenses means like salary, office expenses, trade expenses, wages, rent, advertisement expenses, commission paid, interest paid, all this. And whereas incomes, say commission received, interest received or discount received, any income. So the rule is, debit is all the expenses and losses, credit all the incomes and expenses. Here one more important bifurcation is, this personal account and real account, the carry forward from year to year and both are appeared in the balance sheet. Personal account and real account, it is a continuous nature. It is appeared in the balance sheet and it is carried forward from the year to year. Whereas nominal account, it is a temporary account. At the end of the year, all the nominal accounts are closed to trading account or profit and loss account, and it is closed to, they are not carried forward from year to year. Again, at the next year, it is a. That means nominal account is called a revenue, whereas a real account and personal account we call it as a capital ledger. We'll check one by one general commercial side. Then we'll go for this railway transactions. First we'll check this commercial side. Suppose take the example, Mr. Krishna started a business with rupees 5. Here Mr. Krishna is not lender because it is his own business. So here it is the lender is shown as the sundry creditor. But here is the proprietor. His account should be mentioned as the capital. So first these are the five steps we have to easy for preparing this general entry for any transaction. What are the five steps? The first step is the what are the accounts involved? Because the beauty of this double entry bookkeeping is for every debit there is an equaling. That is the reason balance sheet is carried at the end of the for every debit there is an equaling. So we have to find from the transaction. The first step is to find the two accounts involved in the transaction. And the next step is the type of account. That means after finding this two accounts, this under what category the account is concerned, you have to find whether it is a personal or real or not. Then you have to apply the rule of the term. That is personal, which is typically similar, related to your name. Then by going to that rule, we have to see if this account is a debit or credit. And the final step is the we have to prepare general. This is the useful for the candidates who started this bookkeeping beginning. So here the general is getting transaction. It's involved five steps. The first step is the accounts involved. Second step will find out the type of account. Last step the loan means rule of the account. And fourth step whether it is a debited or credited, and the last step is the preparing general. Now we check Mr. Krishna started business with rupees 500 rupees. Here what are the accounts involved? One account is Krishna and another account is the cash. Since Krishna is the owner, we cannot call it as a Krishna account. We can call it as the capital account because he invested the cities. So that means it is the first amount is the capital, second amount is the interest. See, capital means we already discussed. So all personal accounts is comes in the category of personal. So personal account means what is the loan? Debit the receiver, credit the. That means here Krishna is a receiver or giver. He is the giver. He is the giver. He is given the amount to the business. He invested in the business. That means here Krishna is the giver. That means this capital account should be credit. Capital account is the credit. So automatically the opposite account is debit. Anyway, we check this, the cash transactions from the bank. So what is the second account involved? The second account is involved is the cash. It is a type of real account because it is a property, it is an asset. So it is a type of account, is a real account. Then we invoke the rule, a real account rule, debit what comes in, credit what goes in. So here, their cash is receiving in the business or going out from the business. So it is a receiving in the business. Receiving the business means we have to post this cash account is the debit. That means finally the cash account is debit and capital account is credit. So the general entry is cash account account to capital account. Narration that provide being the capital provided by the document. Now we check the second entry. Second entry, this is withdraw 1000 rupees from bank for personal use of movement. Here bank can be treated as a personal account because he is in the dollar account or cash. So drawings is the personal account. Drawings here, the proprietor is receiving the money. But since he is the proprietor, the at the time of withdrawing, his account is stated as the drawings. So here, both are personal. And here personal account rule is a debit the receiver, credit the giver. Who is giver? The bank is given. That means it is a credit. And who is the receiver here? He is the proprietor, is the receiver. So proprietor is the debit. Proprietor means here drawings. So drawings account that are bank account is the narration is being the amount for personal use of. It's a personal use only, we have to operate in the bank's account. Otherwise, if it is the company's expenses, either office expenses or rent or other expenses, you have to debit the concerned expenses, not price. Since it is used for personal use, you have to debit the price. And third entry, paid salary. Paid salary is 5,000 to Mr. Krishna. Here what are the accounts involved? Here accounts involved is salaries and cash, not Krishna. Why? Because Krishna is rendered services to the company, so he is able to receive his salary from the firm. So here Krishna account is not appeared. Why? Now we should discuss that. So here the accounts involved is the salaries account and cash account. So salaries account to just discuss the all expenses are concerned on salary nominal account, it's a temporary account. So it is the nominal account. The cash is a real account. It's a problem. So if we invoke the rule, debit all the expenses and losses, credit all the incomes and gains. So naturally the salaries is the expenditure to the company. So the salary account is a debit and here the cash account, it is a real account, debit what comes in, credit what goes out. That means here cash is leaving from the operation, goes out from the business, not comes in from the business. So here the cash is the. That means salaries account that are to cash account rupees 5,000. In the narration we have to write being the salary paid to Mr. Krishna. not in the upper. And last entry in the commercial side, then we will go for railway transactions. Sold goods for cash, rupees 3. So here, what are the accounts involved? It is a goods suffered on cash. Goods suffered means a real account. Cash account also. That means if you apply the rule, debit what comes in, credit what goes out. What comes into the business, is the cash, because it is a cash sales. So cash is received in the business. So cash account is debited. And goods are going out from the business. So goods account, that is a sales account, is that means cash account at all, because cash is received inside the business. And sales is the goods are left to business. So sales account is the, we are being the cash sales. Now we check the railway transactions. Now we come to railways. Railways we operate with general messenger, civil server, MCR, and the rail BJP and capital. The first two are the cash transactions, and the two are the adjustments. Now check the first example, paid the salary of the PFA official officer. So what are the accounts involved here? It is a salary support and then bank account or cash. So salary support, first we'll check the left side. So salary support means the railways, he is the part of administration staff. So he is commander, the extra command number 03 or sub-manager at the point. So salary is being an expense to the railways. It is comes under nominal account. Nominal account, temporary account. So what is the rule? Nominal account, debit all the expenses and losses, credit all the incomes and the fees. So here salary is being an expense. It is a salary is being an expense. It is comes under debit side. And so the salary support is debit. Here this bank is the real account, that is cash, debit what comes in, credit what goes out. This is a cash is going out from the railways. So see, whenever this cash outgo, we are operating the checks and fees. Because in the other companies, in other firms, only one account is issued, cash account or bank account, for both incoming and outgoing. Whereas in the railways, whether it is outgoing, it we are operated the checks and fees. In case of incoming cash, we are operated the remittance into bank. So checks and bills means that is nothing but the checks issued against the bills passed. Checks issued against the bills passed. So here it is a real account. Debit what comes in and credit what goes in. So here cash is going down. So it is the credit transaction. Here one account is debit means automatically other account is the opposite part, credit. So what is the general entry? S12 demand number 03 account is 50,000. To checks and bills account, the relation is being paid the salaries of the account. Here I told you the banked account should not be debited. Because here banked account is not current, because the railways pay salary to in the discharging of the services to the railway. Suppose if the record account is entered in the reports, he is considered a personal account and he is supposed to repay the amount to railways. But in the actual sense, it is not required because he rendered his services. So that is the reason we have to limit the salaries, not personal account. Now we go for the same example. but the paid housebuilding advance stops moving. Here it is a personal. Here it is a personal because he is the obligated to repay the amount to the writers in the course of service. So here it is a not a nominal amount, not an expenditure to government of writers. So what is the transaction? Paid housebuilding advance to stops rupees 15 crore. What are the accounts involved? Here accounts involved is the HPA or Venkat. That means HPA sanction to the Venkat. And the second transaction, the second account is the bank account of GCPS. Now we'll check the HPA and Venkat. So this Venkat account is considered personal account. We have to invoke the rule debit also. Debit the receiver. Here debit the receiver, credit the debit. Debit the receiver, credit. So here, it is a since Venkat is the receiver of this, receiving this rupees 50,000 from writer, his account is debited. His account means not by name Venkat, it is account debited on the HPA, but in the HPA register, you have entered the name of Venkat in the HPA register. So it is as good as it is a debited to Venkat only. But the head to your operator is the HPA account, civil tax, housebuilding advance. Now we check this second item. This is the bank, this is cash is going out from the writers. It is comes under real account. Cash is the real account. The rule of real account is the debit what comes in, credit what goes in. So here cash is going out from the bank. So it is a call. So the general HPA account, check service. The relation being the HPA being the HPA paid stops. Now check one more example. It is the cash received in station booking office on investment from a passenger. That means a passenger purchased a ticket for his travel and then he paid for his ticket and 500 rupees from this. So how to enter this? So here accounts involved is the passenger earnings and cash. Passenger earnings and cash. Now we'll check the first one. Passenger earnings means it is a income to the riders. So it is considered the nominal account because nominal account covers all expenses and income. So since it is being an income, it comes under the nominal account and the nominal account rule is the debit all expenses and losses, credit all incomes and gains. Since passenger earnings is nothing but it is an income to riders, it is a credit to this income. So passenger earnings is credited. Now we check the second one. We have received cash. We have received cash in the banks. Cash is the real account. What is the real account? Debit what comes in, credit what goes in. So here cash is received to the rider, going out from the rider. It is received to the riders. So since it is received to the riders, this cash amount is debited. I told him that cash is going out, we operated this check service head, the cash is received into the railways, we are operated remittance in the bank. Because the cash, station cash is collected to cash office and cash office people is remitted into the bank. Remitted into the bank. That is the reason this head is always called as remittance into bank. Remittance into bank, that means cash is remitted into bank. So it is a year of work. They've been gone from celebrating God course of EFL's caches. Coming into the guidance for the so the general entry is a remittance into bank about the car is buying and to offset the X because offset X is different for passenger remittance. Offset Y is different for goods remittance. Offset Z is different. So it is a passenger remittance. The offset X is credited to the rupees buying. The narration is being accounted in the passenger. Now we will check with the last entry. Shortage of stock, both is during physical verification of goods. The first three entries are taken as cash transactions. Cash transactions means either checks entry or RM. Now we come to this adjustments portion also. Because in the general revenue change and capital change, we are supposed to record general entries. Here, what are the accounts involved? The shortage of stock means it is put under stock adjustment. Because stock adjustment account is a suspense account, it is covers all excess stock or shortage of stock, physical verification or round of value or anything. So, during the physical verification of ASP, this rupees 1000 worth of stock will be shortage. So, what are the accounts involved here? One is inventory account, that is the stores in stock, because the stock amount is reduced by amount of 1000. And another is the suspense account, this is the stock adjustment account to cover this shortage of stock. Since stock adjustment account is nothing but it's a loss, it is a loss to driving. Since losses are covered under nominal account, debit all expenses and losses, credit all incomes and here stock adjustment is nothing but it is a loss because it is a shortage of stock. Since it is a loss, it is a debited. So stock adjustment account is. Now we check the second aspect. Here it is a stores in stock. Stores in stock means inventory. Inventory means it is a type of property. Property means it comes under real account. The real account rule is debit what comes in, credit what goes out. Debit what comes in and credit what goes out. Here the stock is coming into the railway or going out from the railway since it is a loss. It is the stock is reduced. That is more from the bank. So it is credited. It is credited. So the general entry regarding JV is stock adjustment account regard because it is a loss, it is credited from the amount of this 1000. And to stores in stock because to the extent the stores in stock is reduced. So normally all properties accounts are debit balance. Or debit balance, that means stores in stock account is always debit balance. Since it is reduced by 1000, this amount is credited. The stores in stock is credited. That is the narration is being the loss of stock accounted into stock adjustment. Now we check one more adjustment. I raised a bill on Mr. Govind for rent charges of railway, that means our railway building is being rent to Mr. Govind, and we are raising bill rupees 500 crores. That is called demands incurable. That is considered demands incurable. And here he is called as Govind is called as the debtor to the bank. Debtor to the bank. So what are the accounts involved? The demands incurable account or debtors account. And the second one is, this rent charges of railway building or lease charges of railway building is part and parcel of sundry entries. The second entry is called sundry entries. That is called sundry entries. This is the second one. So it is an income to be balanced. Now we will check the first one. Demands incurable or debtors. So here, who is the mentor? Here, mentor is the Mr. Kohli. Mr. Kohli is the personal account. Mr. Kohli is the personal account. So the personal account tool is the debit the receiver, credit the receiver. Since he is the receiver of this charges, so he is the debitor. And here Sundry means is the, it is a nominal account. So nominal account means debit all expenses and losses, credit all incomes and gains. So it is a income, it is called as the credit. So here demands recoverable upon data to abstract Z and means account. See, this demands recoverable is the one of the linked. Demands recoverable is the one of the linked. So it is operated on the earning side. Earning side always credit balance. See, the suspense center operated on the earning side always debit balance. So demands recoverable is always debit. So in the first entry it is a debited by crediting to abstract Z and this is fine. Now the same entry, suppose if you receive the amount from the Mr. Govind, now check. So receipt of rent, the earlier transaction basically fill up the rent charges on the Mr. Govind. Yeah, I share this document of end of the session. So, receipt of rent and railway billings from Mr. Govind, that is 500 rupees. So, what are the entries? That is in the first step, this is the bill raised. In the second entry, the amount is received from the Govind. So, what are the accounts involved here? One is the cash account, because we have received cash. And another account is the personal account, Govind account or demands account. So, demands recoverable or Govind account is the personal account. The personal account rule is the debit the receiver, credit the giver. Since he is the giver, his account is credit. His account is credit. Since cash is the real account rule is the one. Debit what comes in? Credit what goes in? So the real account rule is that debit what comes in, credit what goes out. Here cash is receiving the rights. So this is a debit. Since already I told this cash received always here accounted under debits, that cash going out is always accounted under checks and checks issued against bills. Here the remittance into bank. Now this amount is remitted in the our total. So that's why this cash is a debit, that is a remittance to bank account that are 500 rupees. And this Govind account is the credit because he is the giver. Govind account means it is a account under the demands. So remittance to bank account that are to demands account of that is 5. So being the receipt of rent charges from Mr. These are the transactions. Any doubts, please raise hands so that we will cover any examples if you want to. Well, any examples, I will try to cover these transactions. Or you can type your transactions in the chart box also.
Okay.
please tell me, giving credits.
मासी किस था भरा से ये था आया हुआ मेरे पास कहाँ निकला है सारा फाइल
अगर उस एंड मोड टेक्स्ट वन
हो गया
वर्ड
आया हुआ है तो कहाँ रुक गया सारा फाइल तो पेंडिंग पुराना निकाल दिया था
सो डिस्कस इस कार का चाहिए एंड योर माइनस डेबिट एंड माइनस क्रेडिट ऑपरेशंस Now we'll discuss this contract. Because line accounts, COCR and MCR is allowed revenue transaction and capital transactions both in the COCR and MCR. But when coming to JVs, this general, we are maintained separate for revenue, separate for general for capital. So any transaction involves one capital and one revenue. Is can operate in this single transaction either in revenue or capital because both are separate. So what to do? So we will check one example. This on 1st January 2021, this WMS is clearance and debiting this POH of the purchase. So WMS means all of you know this planet 72, this concept of demand number 16. And POH of purchase is the demand number 6. That's the demand number 6. So how to record entry both the revenue as well as capital. So here the involved transactions is the revenue general voucher and capital general. The transaction is the WMS is clearance. And it is debited to POH of the purchase. That is WMS of the credit. And POH of purchase, the demand number 6 is the debit. How to prepare
this
contract? First, we will get revenue
generated.
The revenue generated is only an operator for the revenue transactions and subsequent transactions. So, in the revenue transaction, we are debited demand number 6. This transfer capital means from revenue we have transferred to capital. So this transfer capital is 1000 rupees we have to look at. Then we have to go for this capital check. In the capital check, what is the transaction? It's the clearance of WMS. Clearance of WMS means WMS account should be credited. WMS account should be credited. So first we operate. This is 1/1/2021 by WMS. Here, this by WMS. So we have posted credit side. WMS account is the 1,000 rupees. But to revenue JV should be matched. So in the revenue JV, we posted transfer capital credit side. So equally, we have to post contra item. Contra item in the capital JV debit side, transfer revenue. That means we have to operate transfer capital in the revenue books. And at the same time, in the opposite side, we have to operate transfer revenue in the capital JV. So yeah, it is a demand number 6 is debited. And WMS amount is credited, our purpose is served with the help of the transfer capital and transfer revenue. The revenue books we operated transfer capital, the capital books we are operated transfer. If you check this heading, in transfer, I think 0087-82, you see one debit bill, one credit, it is a transfer capital, you put credit 1000, but it is a transfer revenue, it is put 9192 is the subunits under 8782 variant. So here one debit, one credit, both are tallied, it is a nullified. This transfer transaction is the. So here one important point number is, this transfer capital or transfer revenue should not occur minus something. That means we can tally the change by posting this transfer capital as minus debit 1000, but it should not be. Only transfer in general heads can operate to minus debit, minus credit. But transfer railways and transfer capital and transfer in the heads should not operate to minus credit. So minus credit is not one of the. So by nullifying this transfer railways, one debit and one credit, what is the net general entry is available in the books is the demand number 6 support is the debit and WMS support is the credit. What for the this is contra-general. And we discuss what is this operation of debit or minus debit and credit and minus credit. See, this minus credit or minus debit is the feature of the Indian Railway support system. You cannot see this system in elsewhere in the world. Nowhere in the world, the minus system or minus credit is operating in the Indian Railway system. What is the necessity or object of operation of this minus credit? Here, when an employee goes on transfer from one unit to another unit, the supposed to transfer this HP amount to another unit or the transfer to another unit. So, in this case, the minus debit is operated in the general case instead of credit. Instead of credit, we have to operate. The main important thing is the object or advantage is to avoid budgeting effect. Suppose if you transfer the debit to other linkers, in that other railway also that the HP amount is debited once again. Because at the time of sanctioning it is debited in our railway and when it is transferred to other railway, if you transfer the debit, again it is a portion in the debit side. It is as good as the both times it is the expenditure. So to avoid a double budgeting effect, because see, suppose the general entry in the books of outbound unit, that means employees transfer from A unit to B unit. Now A unit is initiated this transfer certificate, that is a transfer of H to A. So since it is in the books of A, it is the HP amount this is debited. Since the employee is transferred, it is the same thing, the same amount is a credit. But instead of debit to transfer divisional, it is given minus credit.
Which is correct, debit?
Because the debit is other unit, again it is a double debit. So to avoid that, here we operated instead of debit, we operated minus credit to one. That is transferring employees and HPA debit balance to one like unit. So what is the entry recorded in the receiving rail? Receiving rail means this is the unit B. He has taken this this 1 lakh, they have taken as the minus credit. Minus credit means it is nothing but debit. So it is indirectly the salary is appeared in the debit side of HPA, but in the records it is posted as the minus credit. Minus credit means it is nothing but debit. and you offered a credit for transferring the so the gearbox is a minus credit transfer digital. The unit 3 books is the transfer digital is the credit. So transfer digital minus credit and transfer digital credit both are qualified. Both are qualified. And you see the records of A unit is reduced by 1 lakh. And in the unit of the books of unit B, this HP account is increased by 1 lakh. How it is increased? It is by operating the minus credit operation. Suppose if it is operated instead of minus credit, again it is a debit. It is a double time sanction. It is a two times, it is a debit appeared in the spin graph. But the graph is only one time. So that is the reason, instead of operating debit, we are operated the minus. So the above transactions, the debit balance of HPA in the books of unit A is reduced to that extent. The debit balance of HPA in the books of unit B is added. Though it is a debit balance, the transactions are affected through minus credit to avoid budget effect twice. That is one at the grant of HPA at unit A and another at the accepting the debit at that is the main option. And some other examples of this minus credit and minus credit, especially in the clearance of checks and fees. So in the first instance, the checks and fees account is credited, and in the, at the time of clearance of checks and fees by credited, DSP suspense was minus credit, not credit. At the same time, similarly, this remittance into bank accounts also cleared by operating minus debit to remittance instead of credit. And all Indian intra-railway transfer, intra means it is within the journal, inter means from journal to journal. See, inter-journal transfer is a per-contra debit, per-contra credit. Yeah, 1 minute. So some more examples is the clearance of checks and fees is a minus credit, we have created clearance of RIP, we have created minus debit. And income is within the digits, among the digits in the journal railway, we have created this transfer digital at the minus debit and minus not contra.
हाँ सर आपका काम हो
जाएगा
बहुत में परेशान कर रहा है मैडम को इतना देर
से
मेरी पास आएगा हम देख लेंगे सही होगा तो हम कर भी देंगे होगा तो हम कवर भी कर देंगे
So there are the five stages. The first stage is the transactions, that is the events or transactions. And second stage is the transactions are recorded in the journal, recorded in the our books, that is journal entries. And not only is it classified as the ledger, there are the different heads. And from the ledger balances we have prepared trial balance. And from the trial balance we have prepared transactions in the ABC Limited. It is a startup business with 100 rupees. That is the capital invested is 100 rupees. cash purchase is the 50 rupees, and cash sales is the 60 rupees, and wages paid 5 rupees are taken with small place to understand that salary is 5 rupees, and the company's purchased furniture for 50 rupees, and we recorded depreciation on furniture 5 rupees because the total of these 4 years we are recorded with 25%. And we have taken loan from the Krishna, that is 20 rupees, and we paid interest on the loan. These are the transactions happened with the ABC. Now we check the out reserve. So, adjustment is the closing stock. Closing stock is the number of the purchases minus sales. So what is purchases? 50 units and the sales is 40 units. That means 10 units at the rate of cost price, that is 10 into 120 units. The closing stock is value to increase 10. This is the adjustment. Now we'll check the general expense. General expense, we have to apply the rules of debit and credit, and we have to look at the general expense. So startup business means is the cash upon the government capital, or purchase upon the government cash, because cash is going out, goods are received, and cash upon the government sales, because cash is received in the form, and goods are left in business sales, and wages upon the government cash, because wages is an expense, is a normal account, is a debit. And cash account is going up from the business, is the credit. Like that, salaries support the cash. And furniture, purchase furniture for the cash. See, furniture is the asset, is the debit. What comes in credit, what goes up, cash is going up, the furniture is coming inside. Depreciation is an expense, so it is a debit, and furniture account is credited. So because to that extent, the furniture account value is reduced. So furniture account at the time of purchase is debited, and at the time of depreciation, we are credited. And we receive cash from Krishna as a loan. Loan means we are paying from Krishna account as a credit card, and cash account, since cash is received in the business, it is a debit. And we paid interest on the this loan, that is 2 rupees. That means interest is an interest paid is an expense, it is a debit, and cash is paying, it is a credit. So these accounts we have to prepare. The next step is the ledger. Ledger means we have to prepare this cash account, capital account, purchase account, sales account, wages account, salaries account, furniture account, depreciation account, and interest. These accounts we have to prepare. These general expenses has to be posted in the ledger. Ledger means the capital, prepared capital, cash, purchases, sales, wages, salaries, furniture, depreciation, and Krishna and interest. I have taken only one or two transactions. Cash account normally is maintained a subsidy book because a lot of transactions enter in the cash. That's why you paid cash book. See, the cash book opportunities are there. See, the capital account is the always credit balance because it is a nothing but it is a creditor. Since it is the amount provided by the owner, it is called as capital. And cash is the real account, it is always debit balance. It is always debit balance. All properties are always shown as the debit balance, the real account. So it is the debit balance 98 rupees. And purchase account is a debit balance. It is a transfer to trading account. So it is 250 rupees. And sales account, it is a credit one, who's going up. So it is the credit account, it is also closer to trading account. Wages account, since it is an expense, it is a debit balance, it is also closer to trading account. but this capital account, this can come out from the capital of cash, because this is a personal, this is the real account. All personal and real accounts should be entered in the balance sheet, not the P&L account or P&L. And salaries account also is an expense, temporary or nominal account, this is also close to P&L account, profit and loss account. Furniture account, it is a property, so it is recorded in the balance sheet. It is carried forward from vehicle, nominate donors or assets accounts is the debit balance. Depreciation, it is an expense, it is closer to P&L account. All non accounts close to our personal accounts also, it is carried from year to year. Here, Krishna is the creditor, he is giving money to business. His account is a credit balance, it should be posted in the balance sheet, liabilities side. And interest is the nominal account. Interest is the nominal account. It is closer to P&L account. Now, the three stages are transactions. And it is posted as a journal increase, and we have prepared a lecture from the journal. And next step is to prove the arithmetical accuracy of the all the transactions. We have to prepare trial balance. We have to prepare trial balance from the ledger balances. So we have to take out all the ledger balances into the trial balance. Trial balance is nothing but it is a base for preparation of final accounts as well as to prove the arithmetical accuracy of the all the transactions. If you record this capital account is a credit balance, means we have to post credit, debit balance means we have to post debit. We check this capital, cash, all the entries. It is the total is 180 rupees and 180 rupees. That means 180 rupees. It is the trial balance debit, trial balance credit is proved arithmetically. Then the last stage is the final accounts. Prepared final accounts. See, final accounts, it consists of trading account, P&L account and balance sheet. See, the trading account and P&L account is only covers nominal accounts. That means all nominal accounts are closed for trading account and P&L account. Whereas this real account and the personal account is carried forward to balance sheet to know the position of the company at the end of the day, which is the last day of the financial. So this is a trading account to be prepared for the year, spending so and so. Already on the all nominal accounts are posted in the trading and P&L account. So trading account, the object is to identify this gross profit. So 50 rupees purchases, sale 60 rupees. And that means by these two transactions we can know this is the profit difference. But we will check. Because closing stock also we will take it to the account to arrive the gross profit. That is closing stock is the adjustment. Adjustments means we have to post two times. Because if it is a general entry, it is posted as a debit and credit. Since it is not comes on the general entry, we have to take this amount as the two sides. One is a trading account credit side, another is balance sheet asset side. Because the leftover stock is treated as the property or asset. Current asset. So the sales is 60, closing stock 10, the total of credit is 70 rupees. The debit side, the wages were incurred in the trading account. So 50 plus 5. So the balance 15 rupees is carried forward from P&L. Gross profit is carried forward from P&L. So this gross profit is carried to P&L for this 15 rupees. And we have to adjust other miscellaneous expenses in the business. That is called salaries, depreciation, interest. We have to adjust to P&L account. So the total amount is 5 plus 5 plus 2, 12 rupees. The profit is 15 rupees. So the balance is called net profit. So since it is a sole proprietorship, if the owner is only one person, this net profit is added to the capital of the provided by the
madam.
So this trading account, P&L account will be prepared for the year, whereas the balance sheet is prepared as on also, that is 31st March. Already I told you this only balance sheet covers real account and nominal account. Sorry, real account and personal account. That means the owner's account is a capital and personal account means sundry debtors and sundry creditors and all assets are common part of this balance sheet. The balance sheet is tallied, it is nothing but the rule of debit and credit. For every debit, there is an equal credit is satisfied. And there are two arithmetical equations also. Yeah, we'll check this balance sheet. See, capital is 100 rupees. This net profit credit is added to the capital, that is 103. And this Krishna has given loan to company. Is nothing but sundry creditors, liabilities, is 20 rupees. On the asset side, we purchased the furniture 20 rupees, but depreciation 5 rupees, so net amount 15 rupees. On the cash balance 98, on the closing stock 10 rupees. So it is 123 and 123 is 10 rupees. So that means it is the accounting cycle. Accounting cycle means from the beginning to end. That is transactions, journal entries, ledger, file balance and final. Yeah, I'm going to unmute all of you. Please tell me
doubts. Sir, HBA transaction, 1 second, sir.
Pardon? Yeah,
debit and credit balance. सर डेबिट एंड ट्रांजेक्शन सर कैसे डिटेल ट्रांजेक्शन बताइए सर
हाउसिंग लोन ट्रांजेक्शन
या हाउसिंग लोन ट्रांजेक्शन सपोज हाउसिंग लोन इज सैंक्शन टू एम्प्लॉई इन वन फाइल वे फॉर हाउसिंग लोन इज अकाउंटेड डेबिट इन द बुक्स हाउसिंग लोन इज डेबिटेड इन द सैंक्शनिंग राइट बट दिस डेबिट इज ट्रांसफर टू अदर राइट The debit balance of house building advance to be transferred to other liability. How to transfer? You should not transfer the debit balance. If you post the debit balance, again if the other liability is incurred in the NPA amount in the debit side, it is a double debit in the overall retail value rates. But here, so to avoid this double budget, we have to post, we have to transfer as the minus credit to have transferred and the other unit is accepted as the minus credit. Other unit is accepted as the minus credit. Minus credit means it is nothing but it is a debit only. Because credits and recoveries are outside the scope of budgeting. Budgeting is the gross budgeting. So whatever adjustment we have done in the credit side will not affect the budgeting. That is the reason. They can accept it as a debit, but it becomes a double side, double sanction, two times sanction.
Sir, one question, sir.
Yeah, please ask.
Sir, station deposit cash through CR notes are in cash office, and cash office to bank, sir, bank to RBI, sir. Iska yeah. General entry kaise karenge, sir?
Yeah, please tell me. The amounts received in the railway, sir, deposit,
Station deposit, sir, station deposit cash through CR note in cash office.
Yeah, yeah.
Cash office to bank and bank to RBI, sir.
Yeah, yeah total, sir. Nothing but the journey of the rupee from the cash of, from the booking office to RBI. That is nothing but journey or book. Duty from booking office to party. Okay. The first entry is cash received in booking office. Now the journal entry is R&D account record. That is, say example, it is 100 rupees. So this 100 rupees is remitted into the bank. 100 rupees is the remitted into the bank. So the cash acknowledged by DST bank. So at the time, this remittance to bank RIP account is minus debit. Minus debit 100 rupees. So in the first entry, RD account is debit. Next after that is passing the remittance is debit. In the second, when it is accepted by the bank, when sending this daily mail score to the headquarters journal office, we have to operate this RIP account is minus debit on public sector bank suspense. PSP suspense is the debit. And again in the third entry, and finally, adjusted into CAS Nagpur. RBI Nagpur. The entry is this PSP suspense is minus debit and Reserve Bank deposit. So that means this account is nullified. This RIP account is first debit, next minus debit. So it is nullified. And at the same time, this PSP suspense, it is debit 100 rupees and PSP suspense minus debit. That is passenger remittance is the credit and Reserve Bank deposit is the debit. What is the Reserve Bank deposit? It is nothing but the cash account. Cash account of the railways. See, since cash is received, finally the Reserve Bank deposit is debit. and the after TX, that is a passenger and citizen income, it is
funny.
Okay. Any doubt?
और आईबी बैलेंस को क्रेडिट से नलिफाई नहीं कर सकते हैं क्या? और आईबी बैलेंस को क्रेडिट से नलिफाई नहीं कर सकते हैं क्या?
तो फर्स्ट वे ऑफ डेबिट देन क्लीयरेंस माइनस ओके ऑर्डर बुक इट सेस द क्रेडिट बट प्रैक्टिकल साइड फर्स्ट आरबी अकाउंट इज डेबिटर एंड नेक्स्ट इट इज माइनस बट अगेन दिस पीएसबी सस्पेंस इज द फर्स्ट डेबिटर देन अगेन माइनस the final entry is the reserve bank deposit is the debit account and the credit is the is the passenger earnings that is out
okay. If I do credit to RIB balance then what will be the budget in the
yeah it's the upper credit also it is there. But in the practical, we operate minus.
Okay.
Yeah. Please answer this block, please, on the.
Sir, please explain Kanta JV, sir, once again.
Yeah, tell me.
Kanta JV, sir. Kanta JV.
Yeah. Kanta JV, I tell you. Please, sir. Because see check this transfer capital credit 1000 tax or revenue, debit or both nullified. So again, the leftover entries is recorded in the right of 6 is the demand number 6 is the debit and November 6 is the credit. So that means our purpose is served by operating this transfer capital and transfer revenue transactions. So this is the called contract. Contract means we are to operate this capital and transfer revenue.
Thank you, sir.
Any other notes?
Hello. Hello, I'm audible, sir.
Yeah, please tell.
Sir, how can stock adjustment be called as a loss to railway when there is excess stock, sir?
Excess stock, it is income.
Acha, thank you. Matlab, you said that it's a loss to the railway.
When it is a shortage of stock, it is a loss.
Okay,
sir. So, stock adjustment account, it may be a debit balance, it may be a credit balance.
Okay, sir.
Most of the times, it is a debit balance, sir.
Okay.
In few cases, that excess stock we acquired.
Okay.
If the excess stock is there, it is an income. It is adjusted to rentals.
It's unlike stores in stock, like it's always a debit balance, no, sir?
Pardon?
It is not like stores in stock, which is always a debit balance.
No, it is not like, it's not a final ending, it's a suspense.
Okay, sir, thank you.
Sir, there may be a debit on credit, but stores in stock is always debit balance.
Okay, sir.
Suppose you are purchasing 100 items in your house, is it possible to dispose more than 100?
No, sir.
It's not possible. Either we have to dispose 90 or 95 or 99 or at most 100.
Huh.
We have to dispose more than 100. So
the
answer is always
different. Okay, sir. Understood.
It is a different
answer. Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Yeah. One class for the bank reconciliation for examination purpose.
Pardon?
Sir, please take the one class for on topic of bank reconciliation.
Reconciliation. Yes, sir. Please. The second one is the debit card. So it is considered personal account. It is called liquidity to personal. Outstanding expense or outstanding income or prepaid income, income received in advance, or expenses paid in advance, is all liquidity to personal. Yeah, what is SDA? And building is a type of real account, all properties are real. And stores in stock, it is a real account, because it is a stores.
On behalf of Sitara, I thank CM Nageshwar Rao, Senior Instructor,
for his wonderful explanation with examples. I hope all the doubts have been clarified. Tomorrow, the session is on NPS. The speaker is M.P. Rajaturai, Deputy CAOG, Sausan Kutturai, Vishnuprabhar. All are requested to log in at 11 o'clock. The session starts at 11:30 hours. All the participants are requested to please spread the news about the sessions to all their colleagues. We hope that the participation increases much more than what it is at present. Thank you, one and all.
Yeah, thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, thank you, Varunda.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you.
Sir, PPT available in group.
Yeah, I'll share the
thank you, sir. Thank you. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.